because I know I'm destined to be a world champ, man. So, you know, I just keep on taking that dream and keep on pushing, you know, do what I gotta do for my family and, you know, my main goal, man, to be a world champion.
We checking in here once again. Alex the Brick City Bullet in here in Newark, New Jersey. Closing in just a little over 2 weeks out until that return to the ring finally occurs. Up at the Birchwood Manor. But, you know, let's go ahead and catch everybody up a little bit. You know, let everybody know how training and everything's been going. Obviously, it's picked up the tempo and everything. Kind of let everybody know how you're feeling and, you know, as and where you're at right now in training.
I'm feeling good. We got about 2 weeks and a half, so the half of this week, one more week, is going to be the hell weeks, as I call them. And then after that, it's just cruise week. But, you know, this week right now, we in motion of number hell, man. You got to go through hell to reach heaven. That's my motto. So, just some hell weeks right here.
And it definitely picked up the sparring a lot too. Got some good rounds in here tonight. You know, all the people out there, you can't catch that. We can't take you that exclusive and catch the sparring. But you know, got us some more rounds tonight. But you know, let everybody know you know how the sparring work and everything's been going. And you know, how you feeling and getting in there, mixing it up.
I feel good. I'm feeling strong. Starting to feel stronger. Getting good work. Getting real good work. For those who know, I don't spar nobody my size. Never do. Just getting stronger, man, you know, getting my condition up, you know, just getting ready, man, ready to get some more hell on May 31st.
Absolutely, and you know, as you start to stare down May 31st, Al, you know, and that return is just right around the corner now. Now it's right there within grass and everything, you know, mentally, you know, how you feeling right now? How excited are you about getting back in there?
I'm very excited. Very excited. I mean, words can't explain, man. This is my life. I'm just ready, man. I'm ready to. I wish it was tomorrow. I'd get in there and do what I gotta do. But, you know, it ain't. And that's just gonna be more problems for whoever I get in there with on May 31st. And, you know, I'm just ready.
Now, it was, you know, the tempo and everything has definitely been increasing. You know, and as you said, 2.5 weeks out here from fight night. You know, how is the progression of the camp going to go the rest of the way? You know, how do you close out this week and then with two more to go? You know, what's the progression over this next 2.5 weeks to get you fully prepared?
Like I said, hell, man, it's nothing but hell. Tomorrow we're going to do some strength conditioning. Probably Thursday some more sparring. And then it's basically gonna be the same, right back to the same thing next week. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna get more harder and harder. But then after this week and then the following week, we go to fight, nothing but rest, man. You know, rest, keep the weight down, and that's it. Get ready to do what I gotta do, man, for the first.
And part of your training now is something we touched on in the past, but you do a lot of different types of training. You know, your strength and conditioning isn't just, you know, stereotypical strength and conditioning training. It's, you know, definitely forward-thinking exercises, you know, some things that a lot of, you know, quite frankly, people aren't going to do and fighters aren't going to do because it hurts too much. You know, and a lot of those, you know, your boxing training, there's some other things that you do, which obviously the people out there can't find all that. We can't let you that exclusive. But, you know, there's other things that you do here just with your boxing training that's different. You know, this different approach, you know, that you take to everything that you're doing, that different approach has definitely made you a different fighter. What kind of edge do you feel that you have, you know, from knowing what you put, what kind of special work you put in with that?
I feel like my edge is, you hear a lot of people say they want to fight in the gym. Me personally, I promise you, I want to fight in camp. I want to fight in camp. I put myself through hell, man. I put myself through hell, man. Like I said before, my motto is, to heaven, you gotta go through hell, and I put myself through hell. And May 31st, God willing, is gonna be heaven, man, once I get my arm raised to victory, man. You know what I'm saying? So, but I work hard, man. I work real hard. You hear people say that every day, but you got the inside scoop and you see it for yourself that, yo, you can definitely coach son and say, yo, that boy Alex Brick City Bullet Perez, he really does work hard, man. I do crazy stuff, man. I do crazy stuff that makes me go into my fights and I just be really tunnel vision and just really focusing because I was, you know, the fight is won in the gym. I work hard, man. I don't think nobody works hard. That's how I feel. And for whoever I fight, you know what I'm saying, stat high, I'll go even harder in the gym. So, it's just tunnel vision, man.
And May 31st, you get back in the ring. Been a little bit of an absence, away from the ring due to things out of your own control. Tell me what it's going to feel like when you step back to them ropes on May the 31st and you're ready to, you know, perform. You got all your people out there surrounding you. You know, how good is it going to feel to end that layoff and get back in there, get back at work?
I mean, that's a blessing, man. How it feels is like an unexplainable feeling. It's unexplainable. I love it. I love to perform in front of my family and friends and number one supporters. I love it, man. That's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I tunnel vision, man. When I'm in that ring, I'm at peace. I love it, man. I mean, you know, I'm destined to be a world champion. I'm not going to stop. I'll keep on telling you. I sound like a broken record as much as I say. I'm not stopping, man. I work too hard, man. But, I just keep on getting my knees dirty, keep on praying to the man that did. And doing what I got to do and pushing forward and trying my best to put all work in my camps to achieve my goal and my dream is to be a world champion. So, you know, God willing, I do what I got to do and get there. But first step is May 31st.
Absolutely. And to take us home here on this episode, Al, what are people going to see on May the 31st from Alex the Brick City Bullet Perez?
Like I keep on telling y'all going to see number fireworks. Every time I go out there, get y'all fireworks. If I ain't knocking no guy out, I'm going to give y'all fireworks from round 1 through 10, 12, 8, whatever round it got to be. I'm giving out fireworks. It's going to be a show. Y'all got to see it. Y'all got to be there to believe it. And for those who was there in the past, y'all know what time it is. I'll give anybody money to ever say they seen me in a boring fight. Even if I was even my body wasn't there, my body won't let nobody, none of the fans get a boring fight. I just don't know what that is. I love to get in there and mix it up and do what I gotta do. But, you know, May 31st, God willing, my arm be raised in victory and moving forward from there on.
No doubt about it. And everybody make sure they get out to the Birchwood Manor in Whippany, New Jersey. May the 31st. It's a little over two and a half weeks away. But, Al, let the people know how they get a hold of you and, you know, how they can reach out to you for tickets.
You can reach out to me on my Twitter, at AlexPerezBCB, or my Instagram, at AlexPerezBCB. Get at me for tickets or whatever the case may be. Come out there and show support and come out there and see the show. And come out there and see fireworks, man. And the 4th of July coming up, man. I'm going to give you some fireworks. I'm going to give you some early fireworks, man, on May 31st.
A little bit of a preview. All y'all make sure you get out there for it. But, Al, we're going to wrap it up here today. Long, hard workout you put in here tonight. You definitely can see all the work that's going into this effort for May the 31st. And we'll definitely be out there showing that support and ready to watch that fireworks display.
For sure, man. Salute, man. Al Gotti, Perez/BCB. Y'all come support May 31st. Come see, watch the show. Salute, man. John Resolution Sports. We in here, man.
Y'all already know.